Welcome back to the channel, guys. So in this episode we will be covering CVE 2021 40438. So CVE stands for common vulnerabilities and exposure, and it is a identifier of various vulnerabilities which are discovered over the past time, over the past times or previous times. So basically, if someone has given you a CVE, it means they are referring to a particular vulnerability which was discovered earlier and has been marked as the CVE ID which the company has assigned to it. So basically, in today's episode we will be covering a SSRF vulnerability which has been discovered previous year, and its vector is the previous version of Apache HTTP server. So basically, this is the description. It is a P1 or critical vulnerability, and it happens when the Apache HTTP server version is less than 2.4.4. So when the web application has this version, you have to check if this vulnerability is present or not. So basically, whenever you hunt on certain targets, just check which technologies the company is using. You can use various kinds of extensions, including WebAlyzer, which is the most trusted one. You can use this. You can use this extension. It helps to identify the technologies which are used on a particular web application. So if you see that the HTTP, if it is working on an Apache server and its version is less than 2.4.48, you can try this vulnerability on it. And if you get the remote requests from the web server, the vulnerability is present. So let me show you a POC. I don't have any live POC, but there's a program called Barco. And around 2-3 months back, in April month, I have found this vulnerability in Barco. So this is the POC. So let me explain here what's happening. So the URL here is, let me show you first the URL. So this is the complete URL, discover.barco.com, and the Unix parameter is accepting a lot of characters, which helps to bypass the firewalls, and where we will be providing our Burk collaborator link. If you can see, let me show you. So here we will be providing our Burk collaborator link, and this is the complete bypass technique which is used in this case. So we have to craft our own HTTP request. If you can see here, we have to craft the original URI path, and we can add our remote server link at the end of the path. I have used Burk collaborator link for demonstration purpose, but you can use your remote server link as well, or even if you have any kind of web server which you are hosting on a particular VPS, you can use the IPs as well. So this is a little bit explanation because it's a POC, and I have to explain this to the company as well. So yeah, this is the Burk collaborator client, and we will copy the Burk collaborator link. And so this is the complete payload along with the Burk collaborator link. So you will have to copy the entire URL. And just paste it in the browser and check if any remote request is sent to the Burp collaborator client or not. We can see that there are four DNS requests which are received by the Burp collaborator client. But in this case, the vulnerability was transferred to P4 as my Burp collaborator client did not received any HTTP request. But if in your case, if the your server is receiving HTTP requests, then it will be considered as a P1 vulnerability. Else, the company may convert it to P5 as well. Or if you are lucky like me, you will be awarded as a it will be awarded as a P4 vulnerability. So I guess you have understood it quite well. So even if you have any problem, just let me know in the comment section. And that's it for this video. I hope I see you in the next video. Bye bye till then.